What industry is a lot shadier than it seems? Please give this video a thumbs up by smashing the like button. It helps out the channel. Avocado farms. Most of the farms in Central America are taken over by the cartel because of how much money is in selling avocados. The textbook industry. Pearson is the effing mafia. The funeral business preys on people's weakest moments to convince them to buy ridiculously unnecessary stuff. Trucking. The margins are razor thin, and so everyone is trying to nickel and dime each other constantly. The drivers lie to their dispatchers, the dispatchers lie to the brokers lie to the clients. All of this for like $50 to $100 sometimes. Health insurance. In the commercials, it is all about caring for your health and stuff. But if you ever get a serious illness, they will do anything to avoid paying for your treatment. Source: my mother got breast cancer, and her health insurance made a business decision to let her die rather than pay the $40,000 for her treatment. They made that decision, then hired lawyers to make it happen. My mom got to fight them in court while going through chemo. She made it by mortgaging the house. She told me the insurance company caused her more stress than the prospect of dying. I buy insulin every month, and every month I literally have to beg my insurance over the phone about why I need this. It's scummish. CBD. A lot of predatory companies making subpar products with questionable raw materials, and then marking it way the F up, and selling it as a miracle cure to vulnerable and ill-educated consumers. Usually have a high-power legal team on deck, but pay their workers shun no benefits. Not an industry, but higher academia is badly broken. Some of the smartest people are some of the most badly exploited. Old tenured professors limit the number of faculty many departments can have, forcing people to work as postdocs forever, effectively doing all the work the professor should be doing in the first place. Meager pay and long hours, plus constant pressure, makes postdocs some of the most depressed people. The grad students are no better either. A lot of the times, grad students don't complain about ill treatment, harassment, and outright bullying, as they don't want to jeopardize their prospects of graduating. If you're a foreigner, this situation becomes even worse, whether you're a grad student or a postdoctoral researcher. More people died last year over vanilla in Madagascar than cocaine in South America. They've even coined the term vanilla murder. Farmers hire armed mercenaries to guard their crops from thieves near harvest time, and if one is caught, well, let's just say it's in response to all the farmers that were killed by thieves for the same reason. All industries are shadier than they seem. I used to work for a flute manufacturer, and it was shady as hell. I don't want to name the manufacturer, but it was around the 2008 financial crisis, and the place was equity owned and leveraged to effing Mars. The CEO was committing bank fraud and screwing contractors while laying off employees and enriching himself. A lot of hobby fish importing is pretty shady. You have farms of certain types of fish, like bettas, in some areas of the world that are run with the fish in horrible conditions. Which is why a lot of the ones you get at a major chain store are sick before you even bring them home. The stores will blame the fish being stressed, but I've ordered and received hundreds of fish from small breeders and sellers, and outside of quarry catfish, that really enjoy committing suiciding by poisoning their own water. The fish arrive healthy and fine. Outside of boutique fish farming, the way some wild fish are caught is just horrible. The trappers will likely poison the water supply to knock out the fish, then scoop them out of the water, without a care for that area's ecosystem. This has led to depletion of some natural species, to the point they are now endangered. Lastly, boutique fish sellers and major chains do not give half a rat's ass what happens to the fish in the end. This means that people who buy fish like plecus, bettas, goldfish, etc. end up getting sick of them, and dumping them in local waterways, to supposedly get rid of the problem. So in some areas, these fish have completely destroyed the local water ecology because, like other invasive land species, they were never meant to be there. One of the worst offenders is the lionfish in Florida. It's venomous, and has no natural predators, so its population has exploded out of control. The maritime industry. Most of the big companies do things by the book and treat crews well, because they're afraid of lawsuits and unions. But many smaller mom and pop companies break laws and violate safety regulations with reckless abandon because they're not as visible and can stay under the radar, so to speak. It's very common for a small company to ask a captain to do something illegal and dangerous in order to increase profit, and for the captain to comply out of fear of losing their jobs. And that's just the US maritime industry. Sailors from poorer nations who work on ships are often fed little more than rice and cheap ramen for months at a time and paid pennies for their backbreaking work. I love running tugs for a living, but the industry as a whole is rife with shady business. Dietary supplements. It's gotten better, but there's still a lot of half-truths and whole lies. Not all that long ago, it was seriously like the Wild Wild West. As a chef and owner, I would say delivery services, like Grubhub, they take 30% of the sale, leaving the restaurant with basically $0 in profit, and their customer support is a joke. It's like they hate us. Off them. Never again. Domain names. There's so much shady stuff that goes on when it comes to domain names. Cyber squatting, sketchy registrars, domain hijacking, scams, predatory pricing, etc. Worked at a domain registrar, can confirm. Domain squatting is a thing, and so is customers trying to blame you if they make a dumb third-party decision. Here's an example. The registrar I worked at had a rather unique domain name that they sold at a rather interesting time. I can't say what it was, but let's just say it had to do with a certain European country leaving a certain union, and the domain was a TLD with just that word in it. The day after everything went down, the former owner contacted us, passed account security, provided it, and told us to change the owner details to another person. He was all smug about how he made thousands off of this sale. Calls back half an hour later, and what happened? The new owner stiffed him. Didn't pay a penny. But because the guy had called, gone through security, changed the owner details on the domain, and pushed the button to transfer the domain to this other person at another registrar, it was out of our hands and with the registry. The deed was done. And this new person got a nice new domain, with a very hard to get hold of name for nothing. Pet industry. Basement puppy mills. And dogs that are so inbred they can hardly breathe. There are plenty of ethical breeders out there, and some unlicensed breeders are ethical even if in a legal gray zone. But the conditions of some of the so-called puppy mills can be really bad. Sometimes when breeds are mixed, and the pup gets the recessive genes the breeders weren't looking for, they straight up euthanize it, because they know it won't sell. Not to mention how many purebreds are actually not pure at all, and sold as is. Shady. Jewelry, gems, diamonds is pretty dark. Advertising. We don't really give a fuck if it works. We already got your money. Even better, it's practically impossible to say it didn't work. Your sales stayed flat. Just think how much they would have dropped if you didn't run that ad campaign. This will probably get buried, but Glitter, a manager of one of the biggest glitter manufacturers, Glitterx, said in a 2018 interview that most of the glitter they make goes to one buyer for a single industrial use. When asked who the buyer was and why they need so much glitter, she said, "Oh, I definitely can't disclose that." When asked why, she said, "Because they don't want anybody to know it's glitter." Ever since this interview, people have been trying to guess what company or industry secretly uses most of the world's glitter and why they want to keep that use under wraps. I've worked in the environmental industry, so my first thought was that whoever was buying it didn't want people to know, because glitter is an environmental disaster, basically microplastic in waiting. And if it is the boating industry, well, all those little bits of plastic eroding into the sea is not really a good look. The non-profit world. Unfortunately, most people at the top are in it to make a name for themselves, and don't usually care about the mission of the organization. I've heard pretty despicable things about the Komen Foundation, like how very little of the funds they raise actually go to cancer care, and how they sue other charities that they think are moving into their turf. Mattress industry. Specifically, mattress firm. Worked in the mattress industry for a bit at a startup. Basically 90% bullshit. And the worst part? We had a real doctor serve an advisory role for our products. He debunked a lot of nonsense claims about mattresses, like, your pillow is 50% of your spinal support, that the salespeople use to sell you accessories. The salespeople would argue with him, like they knew better. Some of my favorites I learned are, these hip, direct-to-door, in-a-box foam bed companies, like Tuft and Needle, use the same material from the same manufacturer. There's hundreds of them. Just put them in different boxes and sell at wildly different prices. Side sleeper, back sleeper, and stomach sleeper is baloney. You toss and turn at night on purpose to help prevent blood clots. No mattress will keep you from tossing and turning for the reason above. It's a natural thing you're supposed to do. More layers doesn't mean better mattress. A lot of companies add in cheap materials, like upholstery foam, to just claim there's more layers. Maybe one layer of nice springs, then just 10 layers of various types of cheap foam to get the layers higher. One that actually is true is heat. If you frequently are hot at night, foam mattress is not good for you. It's an insulator, and will trap your heat on your body. In general, air and spring are better beds because of heat. Your body needs to dump temperature at night to get into a full, deep sleep. If it's too hot, you won't sleep well.